Welcome to our tutorial about Microfocus Zenrox 2020 and imaging of Windows 10. In this part we will build our golden image that we use with Zenrox to deploy Windows 10 with a Microsoft EDK kit. So you need to download several tools from Microsoft, the ADK, the PE add-on kit, the deployment toolkit, and since Windows 1903 there is an issue with the ImageX tools, you need to download this fix. In my example, I have downloaded the ISOs and I will now mount the ISO from the ADK in my virtual Windows server and then start the setup. I will use the default values from the setup, so passes and configurations. So after the ADK kit, we need the Windows PE tools. This is for deploying the configuration later on and to build the Windows image. We also mount the ISO into the Windows server and start the setup where we use the default settings by the setup. Next tool is the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit, and this is a setup that I install now. Also during the setup will install the Microsoft Workbench. That is the graphical tool that helps me creating my golden Windows image. And last but not least, I now need to copy the ImageX files. So these are the files that I need to change: the image catalog and the image manager. I will now switch to the location where the ADK kit was installed before. This is my 32 Windows program file directory under the assessment and deployment kit, and there is the WSMI folder, and I overwrite both files. Done. Everything is prepared. We can now start the deployment workbench. And here I find it in the start folder. First, what we have to do is create a new deployment share. So my server is a directory with shares pre-built. You should use a disk for it. And under my shares, I'm creating a new deployment share. I'll take a short name, and I change the proposed name also to a shorter share name, and I call it deploy dollar. I add a description of that deployment share, and I use the default values that are proposed by the setup of the deployment workbench. So after this, my share is created, and I will now import my Windows 1903 German Windows 10 that I downloaded from the MSDN in February. I'll mount it to my Windows box and via import, I'm now able to import from the D directory or the DVD drive the mounted ISO into my deployment share. I rename it to Enterprise because I want to deploy the Enterprise version of Windows later. And I also add the version and the language of my disk. So next, what I need to do is to configure the task sequence. Therefore, I create a new task sequence. I have to enter a short name and a long name that's used during the deploy of the image later on. And I also add in the commands the version I'm using of the Windows 10 here. So then I choose a standard client task sequence and the enterprise version of Windows that I want to deploy. The product key isn't something that I deploy here, that's work with ZenWorks. I add an organization name and an Internet Explorer homepage is wanted. Then the local administrator password is something for my ZenWorks deployment. And then I'm ready with the first configuration. So next I need to configure the task sequence for my deployment. First is the configuration of my hard disk. I don't need the BIOS type because I'm only using UEFI partitions. And also the proposed configurations aren't valid for me. I delete now those configuration. And I will add four new partitions on my disk. First is the recovery partition with the partition type of recovery and the size of 450 megabytes. The second partition is the boot partition. With a size of 100 megabytes, and the file system is FAT32. Make it bootable. Don't forget it. The third one is a hidden directory with the MSR partition type and the size of 128 megabytes. And last but not least, my Windows primary partition, which is taking the rest of the hard disk. And I add the variable OS disk for deployment. I close it, and here you can enable the deployment of updates during the installation. I disable it because I want to make it short, and I found it usable to create my own task sequence here for the preparation of the sysprep, and then I need to name it the task variable doCapture, and the value is prepare, and move it down to the imaging. That's a bit easier. And the next task sequence is sysprep. doCapture. Sysprep. And done. So So here we are able to configure the unattended XML, but because of the bug, we do it manually. So switch now to the place where we copied the image files. So this is the VSIM directory, and I will now open from here the image manager. Now I look for the image WIM file that is located in my share. This was imported during my operating system import. So, and that is on share, deploy, and under the sources directory of my Windows. And I will now import that to get my correct answer file for my Windows 10 Enterprise. This takes a while. Now it's ready, and I can close here the image manager and step back to my workbench. And when I go back to here, edit the unattended XML, it opens correctly, and I can switch to my OOB key and change the protect UPC value to 3 for my automatic deployment. I close the windows, the errors are okay, they do not matter. And I close my task sequence. So now I go back to my deployment share, and there is a rule set that configures my task sequence, and I don't need all those configuration. That's why I have a configuration file that includes the things I want to skip. And in the end, I added a finish action shutdown that after my Windows machine was installed and correctly sysprepped, that it shuts down, that I'm able to create my Zenworks imaging files. The last thing what I need to do is to update here my share, because I haven't my Windows PE files ready to create my golden image through this deployment workbench ADK kit and the task sequence. That's what is happening now. And if I go to my machine into my deployment share, I will now find here under boot my WinPE ISOs and WIM files that I copy to a place which is later accessible for my machine.